Extension methods have been a part of C# for many years already, and now C# 14 is bringing an innovation and improvement to that concept with the extension everything idea. That sounds wonderful, yes? You can now add extension properties besides extension methods, and also static members too. However, the question is, will you want to extend everything? It is that old adage, beware of what you wish for. In this video, I will show you the syntax, that will be easy. I will show you how you can add different kinds of members to an existing type. And then, by wanting to extend everything, we will quickly get into trouble. I want to show you where extensions actually end. Where is the part where you will not want to go any further? That's also a part of learning of extension members. So let's get to code, where I have prepared some explanations and some demonstrations for you. This is a very simple model class which exposes three public property getters. The title and the publication year are immutable, but you can add more author names using the addAuthorMutator method. This is the model I will be extending. The first question is, why extend it? Why not add members to the class? There are two reasons for that. One reason is maybe the class is not yours. Maybe you don't have the source code of a class and you cannot change it. The other reason is more profound. Maybe the added members do not belong to that class. Maybe they are an orthogonal concern. And we will start from that. I will be modeling a few orthogonal concerns now. A typical concern is data transfer. You can imagine this book object being transferred as part of some web page. And look at this, another DTO, which accepts the post request when creating a book object. We need to transform book objects into these DTOs in all places where we use them. That is an ideal use case for extension methods. I will do that traditionally first. Extension methods used to belong in a static class, and each extension method would be a static method with the first argument decorated with a this keyword. That was easy. But now we change the perspective. Look at this. Convert a book post DTO, which accepts the data from the post web request, into a book model object. What's wrong with this method? It puts the DTO at the central position in code, which I might not like. I would want to transform a post DTO into a book, but to attach that method to the book. Well, with traditional extension methods, this was not possible. And that brings us to the extension everything concept introduced in C# 14. Syntax first, you would still create a static class, but then there would be an extension block naming the variable which you are extending. That immediately simplifies the methods attached to that variable, because now you implement them as common instance-level methods. Observe that you have access to the book variable here, because it was declared above in the extension block. If instance-level methods were everything you wanted to accomplish, then you can do it this way. It is equally powerful as the traditional extension methods. But now come the differences, because now we have the ability to attach a static method to the type book, not to an instance, but to an entire class. I'm now using this new feature. First, I'm creating the post DTO, pretending that I have received this object at some post action on the web. And then comes the invocation, because we can transform this post DTO into a book by using a very nice and expressive book.from static method. And then comes a substantial question. Why extension members? Why extension methods in the first place? Because this DTO doesn't belong where the book is declared. It goes to a completely different project, a different namespace along with its corresponding extension method. And the other DTO would also belong there. You can imagine this namespace belonging to some web application, a bookstore application that faces the internet, and it normally operates on DTOs. But what about that post DTO? Well, that is also a web application, but a completely different one. It would be a back office application, which doesn't even reference the assembly where those other DTOs are defined. That is the essence of extension methods and extension members now. That justifies the use of extension members. Still, it doesn't tell us when to use it. You have seen one application of extension members in object transforms. Object transforms constitute probably more than a half of any software we write. So extension members are a significant source of power when writing software. But I want more. Let's see what we can do. I might want to ask how many authors there are. I would hide the author names count behind a property getter. This is another thing you couldn't do with traditional extension methods. They were methods. Now you can write property getters and even setters. I will write a setter in a moment. Still, it is a bit dubious because I have just exposed a getter which almost says this operation takes no time to return. And what I'm doing under the hood is actually iterating for a collection and counting the objects. That's really not a good candidate for a property getter. I think in this example it should be better to make an extension method like count authors. More, can we add a field to a type using an extension block? No, you cannot change the object layout, the content, the size, anything that it contains. You couldn't do that with extension methods. You cannot do that with extension members either. So this won't work. And the last area where we might want to do something with a type is to add mutators. Like a method that adds multiple authors. That's the feature not exposed by the original class. It will be easy to implement it just for each through the collection and add each individual author. This is wonderful. Add range operation that for some reason didn't exist on the class. You might add it. Let's go further. Let's see how far this will take us. Merge authors with the sequence by only adding those authors that do not already exist there. Well, this is a hefty piece of logic that also didn't exist in the original class, and now we have it. We can do many wonderful things with an existing type without changing its source code. Let's go further. Can I write a setter for the author names? That is what the original class doesn't support. You can define a setter. That's very interesting. You can even define a setter for the property which already has a getter in the original class. There's no collision, there's no setter there. But does that make sense? Let's see. I would add the authors, yes, but that's not what this property is promising. It would need to clear the authors before setting them. Well, that is where we hit the wall, because clear author, that doesn't exist on the original class. If you choose to write members that will change the object, that will mutate it in a way then you are already on a slippery slope, because you can only go as far as the original type will let you. It's not the setter to blame here, because I could attach a reset author's method and I would face the same inability. I cannot clear the authors, and that is about everything there is to say about extension members. But a strange feeling remains. How come that there are things we can and cannot accomplish with them? Remember how extension methods came to be. They came along with a link, actually. Link was implemented in the form of extension methods. Let me show you. There could be a function that receives a sequence of books, where that is an extension method. Select many, another extension method. Distinct, yet another extension method. The entire link is built in extension methods, but the link comes with a caveat. It only works well if you supply pure functions to it. Beware of passing impure functions, functions that produce side effects, to link operators, because every now and then you will cause a bug by doing that. That same limitation remains when it comes to extension members of C# 14. My advice to you is to just stay away from mutating the objects, and you will be able to implement everything you want.